President, Naga Student Union of Delhi, Mr. Phongsek Khongri Bhosi, former Vice President, Mr. Ramuya Panin, and General Secretary, Mr. Zhaobo Chalunme. My dear young Naga friends, I am extremely happy to come to this annual program when the Governor of Nagaland, Sri Padmanabhacharya, met me and asked me to attend this program. I immediately agreed and gave my consent. The Naga Student Union of Delhi is one of the oldest student organizations in the country. It is doing a great service to the people, especially the Naga students, and more so the freshers coming to Delhi for higher studies. You provide them the care of a family away from home, coming from far and remote places of the country to live in a big city like Delhi can be challenging. You assist them in admissions, career counseling, and help them navigate the day-to-day challenges of living in a big city. You also give them the warmth of culture, kinship. With you here, their parents back home are reassured. My friends, though your efforts, other countrymen get to know about the rich and vibrant Naga culture, you are a glorious example of community support to your people. You have my highest appreciation. Until a few decades back, the number of Naga students in Delhi was thin. I am glad to know that today you are over 30,000 strong. Your presence in Rishikesh, the intellectual and cultural fabric of our national capital. It is indeed heartening to see Nagas excelling in the walks of life. I am a great admirer of the Naga people, their braveries, their strong sense of pride in themselves, and their unique culture. Many of the problems that the Northeast region faces today is rooted in the legacy of the colonial rule. The British rulers, for their commercial and political interests, created a divide between the hill and the plains people. They occupied all the lands along the foothills that connected the two people for their tea, oil, and coal industries. They broke the several thousand years of civilizational continuum of coexistence. They also created emotional distance between the two by fabricating and giving currency to mischievous myths about each other. It is indeed unfortunate that after independence, for long, we didn't adequately appreciate and remember the countless Naga freedom fighters, the Jadoman and Rani Gaidinilu, who gave their life and freedom fighting the British. Naga freedom fighters, veteran parliamentarians, outstanding administrators and intellectuals have made and are making remarkable contributions to building a modern India. My friends, this city is yours. Again, I would like to repeat, my dear friends, this city is yours, and it is the duty of the government. And it is the duty of the government to help you feel the ownership in order to make you and other friends from the Northeast feel safe and secure in Delhi. I have created a special cell in Delhi Police headed by a Joint Police Commissioner from Arunachal Mr. Robin Hebu from the Northeast to address your day-to-day security concerns. I have a minister from Northeast in the Home Ministry, Sri Kiran Rijiju, who can understand your problems and relate with you better. We are making Delhi police more and more sensitive to security needs of our friends from the Northeast. Delhi police has recruited over 450 smart young boys and girls from Northeast in the last 1 year. And we want to further increase the number. Again, I would like to repeat, we want to further increase this number in the current recruitment drive. In the current recruitment drive of Delhi Police, over 6,000 young women and over 28,000 young men from Northeast have applied. I wish them all the best. If you have any suggestions that may strengthen your sense of security, feel free to bring it to my notice. I will do my best, I would like to assure you. The Government of India is committed to ensure that the Naga people have their rightful honor, dignity and pride of place. I know that India cannot be happy if our Naga brothers and sisters are unhappy. Again, I would like to repeat that if our Naga brothers and sisters are unhappy, India can never be happy. India cannot be great unless our Naga brothers and sisters share this sense of greatness. The initiative to resolve the Naga issue for once and all. The initiative to resolve the Naga issues for once and all, to the greatest satisfaction of Naga people, has made good progress in the last 2 years. We are confident that the enduring peace in Naga area is not far away. My dear young friends, you are the future of this country. I can see among you future scientists, doctors, engineers, administrators, politicians, the builders of India. All are builders of India. I wish you the very best in your life and career. I also once again congratulate the Naga Students Union Delhi for their human service to the nation. And I would like to assure my friends, if any problem comes before you, you contact me directly. I assure you that I will resolve your problems. With these few words, I would like to thank you all and for the success of this conference. Thank you very much.